Good evening.
Good evening,
Father. Sisters and brothers, do we have the faith and courage to place our trust in the Lord? When we have doubts and fears, let us look to Jesus crying out, Lord, save me. As you know, our guys at Columbus sponsor a spaghetti dinner for St. Michael's special school to raise funds. People have been very supportive with this venture through the purchase of tickets and sponsorship. Tickets are available this weekend after Mass at $10 each, and 50-50 tickets are also available. This year, because of the virus, it will be a drive-through only on Saturday, August 15th from 4 p.m. until 7 p.m. Even though the solemnity of the Assumption on Saturday, August the 15th, is not a holy day of obligation, we will have a virtual Mass on Friday, August the 14th at 6 p.m. and on Saturday morning at 7:30 a.m. Please continue to pray for our school principal, vice principal, teachers, staff, and students as the new school year begins. Welcome to this place of worship, a place where the cross stands as witness, and where we claim the faith of Jesus Christ. Welcome to any visitors joining us today, and may St. Anne pray for us, and Mary, the Mother of God, intercede for us, and we welcome to those joining us last week.
Celebrate the 19th Sunday in Ordinary Time. As we come together in worship and praise, we extend a warm welcome back to all in attendance. We do encourage your full participation in the sacred liturgy of the celebration by saying all prayers and responses aloud. We also ask your cooperation in silencing all electronic devices, especially your cell phones. Our presiding this afternoon is Father Vincent. Please stand for our entrance hymn.
Heavenly
Almighty ever-living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit we dare to call our Father, bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Book of Kings. At the mountain of God, Horeb, Elijah came to a cave where he took shelter. Then the Lord said to him, "Go outside and stand on the mountain before the Lord. The Lord will be passing by." A strong and heavy wind was rending the mountains and crushing rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. After the wind, there was an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. After the earthquake, there was a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. After the fire, there was a tiny whispering sound. When he heard this, Elijah hid his face in his cloak and went and stood at the entrance of the cave. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And from them, according to the flesh, is the Christ.
who is over all, God blessed forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
That I turn on music whenever I get into my car, or I often turn the TV on the moment I get home. We are afraid of silence. But with all the noises around us, it is difficult to find the voice of God. We need to find a quiet place to listen to the Lord. Each day, we need to spend some time with God. We need to turn off all the noises that we might hear His voice. A small detail in the gospel today that is often overlooked. St. Matthew says that after feeding 5,000 people, Jesus went up on the mountain by himself to pray, and he was there the whole evening, alone with his Father. He stayed at a quiet place to spend time with God. So I would like to ask you to spend some time, at least 5 or 10 minutes a day, to pray and to listen to the Lord, speaking to your heart. And many people choose to go to a silent retreat that they may find the Lord. Praying in silence or going to a retreat are ways to improve our spiritual life. Silence is very important for our spiritual life. Cardinal Robert Sarah reminds us that Jesus himself, before his public ministry, he spent 30 years in silence. The Cardinal says, Christ lived for 30 years in silence. Then during his public life, he withdrew to the desert to listen to and to speak with the Father. The world needs those who go off into the desert because God speaks in silence. In the gospel today, Peter was sinking when he stopped looking at the Lord and looked about him. He was occupied with fear. He was occupied with all the noises of the winds and the waves around him. When he came to his senses and turned back to the Lord, "Why now, Lord, save me?" And Jesus stretched out his hand immediately to save Peter. Sisters and brothers, like the disciples staying in the boat in the midst of the storm, we are living in times of storms of the pandemic, of violence and hatred. When the storms and storm wind comes, we should always fix our eyes on the Lord Jesus. Because if we stop looking at the Lord and turn around, we will be frightened by the waves and winds and begin to sing like Peter. Walking with Jesus and fixing our eyes on him, we will be safe even in the midst of the storms of life. And in praise, we begin to sing, we need to cry out, "Lord, save me." And surely, Jesus will stretch out his hands and save us, like he has saved Peter. Together, let us confess our faith in the Lord. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages,
God from God, light from light, true to God from true God, in God to not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man.
For our sake he was crucified and Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried,
and rose again on the third day, and according to the Scriptures, he ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I profess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The Lord reveals himself to us in word and in sacrament. Strengthened in faith, we come before the Lord with our needs and those of the whole human family.
That Christians may not grow discouraged with the winds and waves of the present time, but take heart in the words of Jesus who says, "Take courage, it is I, do not be afraid." We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who sail on the seas, lakes, and rivers may be protected from danger and be assured of the nearness of God in Jesus Christ and through prayer. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who may doubt the reality of Christ's presence in their lives may find in us the support they need to take heart and not be afraid. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may give us hope and bless us as we begin another school year, and that through the intercession and prayers of Our Lady of Prompt Succor, we may be delivered from all harm to the life and property during this hurricane season. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christ may reach out and take the hand of those who have died in faith, especially those who have died as a result of war and violence. May the Lord and Savior lead them safely across the waters of life to eternal life. We pray especially for Lloyd Hoffman, Art West, Audrey DeSales, who died recently. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of this Mass and the prayers we hold in our hearts, united in the Holy Spirit with Saint Anne and all the saints who stand before the throne of the Lamb, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Together, let us say our family prayer. Loving and faithful God, through the years the people of our Archdiocese have appreciated the prayers and love of Our Lady of Prompt Succor in times of war, disaster, famine, and illness. We come to you, Father, with Mary, our mother, and ask you to help us in the battle of today against violence, murder, and racism. We implore you to give us your wisdom, that we may be your community founded on the values of Jesus, which gives strength of life and dignity of all people. Bless them that they may form their children in faith. Bless and protect our youth that they may be peacemakers of our town. Give consolation to those who have not loved ones who brought us. Hear our prayer and give us the first words to be a voice for life. We ask this to Christ our Lord. Our Lady of Prompt Succor, listen to us. Mother and Emmanuel, pray for us as we may be a holy family.
Thank you.
Jesus, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up the hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you love in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we have lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation. We acclaim. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly in this passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." History of faith. That partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Gregory our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into a light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. To him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. As we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom of God is yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
join the spiritual communion prayer with our brothers and sisters joining us live stream. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come and live spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself only to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of the truth through Christ our Lord. Amen.